I worked at a school, I just wasn't right. I didn't feel like I could concentrate. I hadn't got much sleep the night before. I touched my little sister. She was crying and she came into my room. I had my headphones on to block out the noise. I'm just sick. All the arguing in this house, it's constant. I don't get how we've moved from our old estate to be a family. Now it's just arguing. Mr. Thompson came to talk to me. He's all right. I told him about how people were being shady and spreading false rumours about me and how I wasn't taking it. He said I could go to the hub to stay calm and relax and do my work up there. I didn't want to listen. I knew I wasn't staying. I mean, I've walked out loads of times. I'm not bothered. I walked across to Northern Road down Beacon Street to chill at Vinny's Chicken Shack. All my mates and where I used to live hang at Vinny's. Vinny's like a mate. He chats and listens and even throws in the odd burger for free. He's mad, honest. He picks us up, me and my mates, and we have a bit of a cruise. Sometimes he'll drop us off to do a bit of leaf hitting for him. I mean, he even pays us a bit of cash. He even said to me that since I'm a close mate, he'll still pay me the cash just to cruise. I don't need to do any leaflets. I've started seeing some of the older kids that knock about down at Vinny's. And after school, the other day I saw one of them, Sunny. He's a good mate. He said I could come round to his place whilst his mum was at work. No one would be in. I was there for hours, just messing, and I left at around 7, was it? Anyway, I walked back to High Road and bumped into some of my friends from my old house. We had a right laugh. I miss seeing these guys.
We had a call from school to say you've walked out, and no one knew where you were. I called all your friends, and no one had seen you. So I called the police. Me and your mum were really worried. Your little sister was really upset. Me and your mum put on a brave face, telling her that you'll be home soon. But inside, we were thinking something really awful could have happened.
Mum was crying, which made me cry. I was really scared. I kept thinking that I might never see you again. I just wanted you home.
Suddenly, it was midnight, and the police had turned up. And I knew they were here for me. They were asking for my name and they told me that I'd been reported missing in front of everyone. I considered running, but I couldn't be bothered, so I went with them.
Your stepdad called us stating you were missing. He was really worried. When we got to your house, your mum was really upset.
On the way home, they told me that my mum and stepdad were looking for me and they called them to report me missing. But I'm not missing. I know where I am. This isn't the first time that this has happened. I mean, the police found me here only a few weeks ago. To be fair, they're all right. Just doing the job, and one of them actually used to go to my school. In the car, she was telling me about how I might be at risk. At risk of what, I said. And then she started going on about hanging out with Vinny. I mean, she has no idea about how much of a great mate Vinny is. But I kind of see what they mean about letting people know where I am. When I got home, my mum and stepdad were waiting for me. They told me off for being late and leaving school, and my mum said that I needed to talk to her about making some changes. I was tired and hungry, so I got something from the fridge and went to bed. I do feel bad. I'll probably do it again. I miss my old area, my mates, and my nana. It's been alright talking to you, to be honest. Maybe this happens again. I could try and find Mr. Thompson or pick up my phone or even let my mum know where I am.
You know, you can always talk to me about anything that's worrying you. When I think of what could have happened to you. Tomorrow, we're going to have a really good talk about it, about what's making you unhappy. And we're going to make some changes.